I, Malika Arora, am the moderator for this evening. I welcome you all to the PD workshop. Geetharatan International Business School was established in the year 2004. Gibbs is affiliated to Guru Gobind Singh Indraprastha University, Delhi, and is approved by All India Council for Technical Courses, Ministry of HRD, and Government of India for Technical Courses and Bar Council of India for Law Courses. The institute is accredited as Category A by National Assessment and Accreditation Council and assessed as Category A plus by State Fee Regulatory Committee, a fee committee of Government of NCT of Delhi, and also rated highest rating A by Joint Inspection Committee of Government of NCT of Delhi and GGSIPU. The institute has been rated Grade A by Academic Audit Cell of GGSIPU consecutively from past 5 years. Gibbs has also been rated number 2 by Times B School Survey 2021. The institute conducts postgraduate courses of MBA, MBA International Business, MCA, and undergraduate courses of BBA, BBA LLB, and BLLB. At Gibbs, thrust is on overall personality development of students so that they can face the challenges in their competitive professional life with value-based approach. Apart from providing quality education, emphasis is on to develop leadership qualities, risk-taking abilities, and the decision-making skills right from the beginning of their professional education. Going by this agenda, the institute conducts personality development workshops on regular basis. This workshop on All India Bar Exam format and preparation is a sequel to the aforementioned object. Law students go through various examination on national and international level throughout their curriculum. However, there is one such exam which the law graduates have to appear as soon as they pass their 3 or 5 year law program. Such examination is the AIBE exam. The All India Bar Examination is a national level certification test for law graduates. The candidates who qualify for this exam will be awarded certificates of practice. While the COP allows students to practice in a court of law in India, AIBE is an important exam which the law students have to appear for, and hence proper guidance and mentoring is desired. The objectives of this workshop are to make the students aware about the changes made in the recent AIBE exam, to make the students informed regarding the syllabus of the AIBE exam, to apprise the students with the format and process of the AIBE exam, and lastly, to encourage the students to be well prepared for the AIBE exam. So, without any further ado, let's welcome the speaker for this session, Ms. Shriya Maini. She is an advocate on record at Supreme Court of India. Ma'am is also a visiting faculty at LLC and NLU Delhi. Ma'am specializes in cross-border dispute resolution and is a practicing lawyer in civil, criminal, and matrimonial cases. She is also a graduate of Gujarat National Law University, who then pursued the Bachelor of Civil Laws on a full scholarship sponsored by Dr. Harish Salve. Ma'am also specializes in international criminal law and is a recipient of the Oxford Global Justice Award 2015 for the public international law. She also assisted the president judge of the International Residual Mechanism for the Criminal Tribunals at The Hague, Netherlands. It is a pleasure to have you with us, ma'am. You all can ask the questions in the chat box, which ma'am will answer at the end. Ma'am, you may begin.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much for that lovely, extensive introduction. This indeed puts a lot of pressure on me, which ma'am and you have put. But anyway, I'm so glad that I'm able to talk to all of you wonderful students. So first of all, welcome. I know that we have about an hour or probably even less than an hour, but I'll try to squeeze in as much information about the AIB as I possibly can. Just one simple request, if we can have the share screen option, then I have certain notes which I'd like to share with the class if that could be done, because at the moment I'm not able to present my screen. So if I, that control can just be enabled, please. Or I can send the PDF.
Sure, ma'am. I think I have made you the presenter. Can you just please check if you can share your screen?
Perfect. I think you have done the lead. Yes. Okay. There we are. Thank you so much. Okay, so let's get to this. Okay, so one of the most important aspects of today's workshop, which we're going to talk about, is personality development, of course, but then vis-a-vis the AIBE. So we're looking at All India Bar Examination 2021. It's, of course, an examination which has been delayed much, and finally we have the dates that are out. You've all filled in the forms. So now comes the process of preparation. Now comes the time when you actually need to start preparing and get done with things faster. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to give you certain very essential, interesting points that I'm going to keep on the screen. I'll keep on dabbling with the share screen option on and off. Just get your pens and papers and take notes, because there's going to be a lot of information coming your way. Not only legal information, but also generic information about the exam. So as we know, the All India Bar Examination, like Runal just mentioned, is actually a very enabling examination, because it enables you to practice. You cannot appear in a court of law. Just a minute, guys. I've been in court since morning, so you'll have to give me a second. Yes, so it enables you to practice. It's a certificate of practice, which is very, very crucial, and that helps you appear in court. So it becomes actually incumbent that if you want to litigate, if you want to be a litigating lawyer, an active practitioner who is arguing his or her matters in court, then it would be incumbent that you obtain this particular certificate of practice. So it's a very, very interesting examination. It's quite simple because it's more or less an open book examination. But having said that, the simplicity is also of the factum that you have all these different aspects. I hope the share screen option is off now.
Yes, ma'am. We can't see your screen now.
Okay, but you can see me, because I can't even see my own window now. Usually in meets, I'm able to see myself. So that's what's... just one thing I wanted to ask.
Ma'am, can you just turn off and turn on your camera again?
Yes, I did that. Did that help? Yes, okay, great. Thank you so much. Perfect.
Yes.
So when I go to the share screen, just a minute, I'm digressing. When I go to the share screen, then also my window vanishes. But you can see it, or even you guys can't?
Ma'am, right now we can see your video on. We can't see the PPT that, or the notes that you were sharing earlier.
Okay, let me now again do this. One second. Just a moment. I think the system is acting up. Just a minute. Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am, you're audible.
Okay, so I'm just going to continue. When the system releases, it's going to be fine. I'm just going to continue. So it's an examination, which is about 100 mark examination. It's got MCQ questions. So it's quite simple in the sense that you have four options. There's no difficulty there. There's no negative marking. And it's basically time management, which becomes crucial. So the whole aspect of the All India Bar Examination is time management. That is the crucial bit, right? Okay. So one of the most important things to remember is that there are about 10 subjects. I'll give you the ones that you need to focus on first. So a few of the subjects you know are guaranteed examination questions. For instance, constitutional law, 10 questions for sure. IPC, 8 questions for sure. CRPC, 10. CPC, 10. Evidence, 8. So let me give you 5 subjects, and I'm repeating this again. These 5 subjects, because most of it is procedure and substance in basic civil and criminal law, IPC, CRPC, CPC, evidence, and consti. These are 5 subjects which you must know at the back of your hand, because these are called category 1 subjects along with family laws. So these family law becomes tricky because it's a pool again of information, and I'm not sure how much of it we can obtain, which is why I don't stress too much on family laws. And I say, okay, if you want to do these five, that's also more than enough. So this is category one. So you need to tackle category one subjects first. And thereafter, you need to go to category two. Category two are subjects which are not very, very important in comparison to category one, because the number of questions quantitatively are a lot lesser. For instance, public international law, administrative law, professional ethics, okay, Advocates Act. Now, having said that, company law, environmental law, cyber laws, okay, labor laws. I'm just repeating this again. And if I can release my system out, so my system is hung, unfortunately, so I'm not able to share the screen. Sometimes with Teams, this happens, I believe. But anyway, so just make your notes, and probably once the system releases, we'll have it easier. So category one and category two subjects. Category one being Consti, IPC, evidence and family law. Category two being public international law, admin law, professional ethics and advocates act, company law, environmental law, cyber laws, labor laws, torts, okay? Taxation. So all these ancillary subjects, category two subjects, you have to target what you are interested in. So it will basically be an examination of 100 questions, a mark each, for instance, with four options each, and you have to take the correct one. Now, this is easy because you have the books, but there's no time to go through the books. So most of the times it's going to be tricky because you will not have the kind of time, and they will ask you specifically questions which you can't decipher from the index. Now, what do I mean by this? इसका मतलब यह है कि बुक्स देखने में उस टाइम पे वक्त नहीं बिताना ज्यादा ओके ओनली व्हेन यू हैव टाइम एट द एंड सपोज यू आर फिनिश्ड विद योर एग्जामिनेशन 2.5 hours आर ओवर और 2 hours आर ओवर एंड यू हैव द काइंड ऑफ टाइम देन यू गो टू दैट पर्टिकुलर एस्पेक्ट ओके आई थिंक ड्यूरिंग कोविड दे मेड सम चेंजेस दे प्रॉब्ली मेड द एग्जाम्स शॉर्टर सो वी विल ऑल्सो लुक एट ऑल ऑफ दैट इन अ मिनट बट रिमेंबर टैक्स थॉट्स टारगेट दोस सब्जेक्ट्स दैट यू आर इंटरेस्टेड इन इफ टैक्स डजंट इंटरेस्ट यू Don't sit and start reading taxation laws, whether it's Income Tax Act, Wealth Tax Act, Avoidance, DTAAs, Double Taxation Avoidance Agreements. Don't open it. Open it, say, a tort law. It's easier. It's simpler. Or a Consumer Protection Act, okay? Look at all of that. Who's a consumer? Who's a complainant? What is NCDRC, National Consumer Disputes Redressal Commission? What is the pecuniary jurisdiction there? These are typical questions which can come, okay? So in a consumer protection, visible.
Yes, ma'am, you're visible.
Okay, thank you so much. If you can just give me the control, yes, perfect.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, wonderful. Thank you so much. I think the perils of technology. Sometimes we do have these little hiccups. Anyway, so let's continue. So I was just telling you that there are category two. I'm also hoping that we've not done this before, ma'am. If you can just let me know. I don't assume prior subject knowledge, right? I do all of these basics with them.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So category one and category two subjects are these two distinctions which have been made from, say, a study material preparation. There's no need to do anything extra except for listening very carefully to what I'm saying. And I think those will be very helpful leads for all third years or fifth years or even the ones in their penultimate years to probably clear this examination, because it's a fairly simple examination if you know what you're reading. So like I was saying, you can see on your screen, category two subjects. So say, for instance, PIL, Public International Law, Admin Law, Professional Ethics, Advocates Act, two very important sections of the Advocates Act, because ma'am had also stressed that this is one of the important ones, is Section 35, Section 24. So this is very, very common questions in the AOR exam, in the All India Bar Examination that is often asked, okay? So you can expect a question there. Company law, environmental law, okay? So all the conferences, the Paris conference, the Rio conference, all of those that have been held, polluter praise principles, so very basic authorities on the point or very basic case laws on the point, which have been landmark case laws, okay? So very, very basic case laws, I can say, are also important because those might not be in the Bare Act books that you're carrying. So don't waste your time, which is why I'm saying refresh your memory. Go down to these subjects only when you've done your initial bit of category one, because category one, you must carry a thick fat book for each. And I'll tell you which books also to carry, okay, so that it becomes easier. So you can get in touch with your seniors if they have those books. Don't end up purchasing them, because you may not use a lot of books by the end of it in practice. You may have a niche area, or it may depend, you know, you buy commentaries later on because you change as a lawyer once you become one. Okay, so this is category one and category two. You also have Negotiable Instruments Act, you have a law of contract, land acquisition. So I would say don't go into this zone unless and until you're really interested. You may want to read Indore Development Authority. You know, all these three judge bench, latest land laws have gotten amended, and there's been a discrepancy with Justice Lokur and Justice Mishra giving these conflicting judgments, which have now been referred to a larger bench. So unless you're interested in this aspect, don't dwell too much. If someone likes IPR, read it. So category two subjects, you have to make a choice. Okay, you have to choose. So I would say go to the syllabus. It's available on the AIBE website. Just Google it. Literally just Google All India Bar Examination Syllabus. That's it. When you Google it, you'll get category one and category two. And within category two, you'll get about 12 subjects, 12 to 13 subjects. Please select any 7-8 subjects that you like. Please, you can drop safely the rest of the subjects. Okay, there's no point. Theek se padho, kam padho, taki aram se pass ho jao. You need to pass this examination. You don't need to top this examination. You're not getting any laurels, okay? So focus on passing this examination. That's your first focus. Now, let me give you certain important tips, and then I'm going to go down to getting to specific subject knowledge, and I'm going to give you important aspects of the subject, because ma'am said that feel free to also dwell upon the subject. So individually, I'll pick up a subject and give you some important information which can substantially help you in the exam. So ensure that you make a note of it, okay? Write it down. Bhool jata hai, isliye likhne achhe rehta hai, okay? So one of the most important things that I always give as a tip is flag the BARE Act, okay? Jo aap BARE Act leke ja rahe ho, because it's an open book examination. So almost you'll be carrying the CPC with you, you'll be carrying the CRPC with you. All of these BARE Acts, or even if you're doing it from home, if it's a sit-at-home examination in COVID in general, just keep these BARE Acts with you, okay? Keep these BARE Acts with you and flag them. So in the criminal manual, suppose you have the criminal manual, you must have it flagged. Evidence Act yahan hai, CRPC yahan hai, IPC yahan hai. That's the first tip. Second tip, very important that you must look at time management. One of the most crucial skills to passing this examination, okay? There are some questions which talk about sections directly. Say, for instance, it will say, Section 32 of the CRPC deals with, and it will give you 5 options or 4 options. Now, these are the easiest questions to do. Why? Because all you have to do is go to the BARE Act, open it, look at these questions and just match the section number. So index will help you. So if you know where Evidence Act Section 54 is and you can open it within 30 seconds and have an answer, you're done. So I think this is a very, very good tip, because about 5 to 8 questions out of 100 will be section based, purely section based. So this is completely brownie point. Lekin atak mat jana. Kai bari they say, for instance, FIR, concept of FIR is enshrined in section dash of the CRPC. And they give you 5 options or 4 options, 154, 152, 153, 155. Now, when you open all of these sections, you will not see FIR written anywhere. There will be no first information report written anywhere. But I know that FIR comes in 154. So you have to be careful not to waste time. If you don't know the concept, sometimes these questions can get misleading. So be careful here, okay? Now, one of the other tips that I always give anyone who's writing the AIB is check the last option. This is tip number 3. Usually the last option is both 1 and 2, either 1 or 2 or all of the above. So be careful. Don't be in a hurry, okay, to mark this computer-based test. Don't do that. Or even if you're giving it physically, be very careful that you check all the 4 options very, very carefully, okay? And this is perhaps the most important tip that I can give you all for today's evening session. Kuch bhi mat yaad rakhna mere jo ab main batane ja rahi hu usme. Lekin ye zarur yaad rakhna ki previous year's question papers, if you do last 5 years question papers, you're sorted. Last 4 years, last 3 years, whatever, since whenever they're available, just do the All India Bar Examination question papers from about last 4 years. As simple as that. Okay, now without wasting any more time, let's get first down to consti. Now, there are certain important topics in consti law which I'm giving you, which you can make a note of that you must always touch, okay? Now, basically, first and foremost, sab se pehla consti kar rahe hain, write it down, constitutional law. 10 questions aayenge, toh it's quite scoring. Isme se agar 5-6 bhi correct ho gaye, toh there are briny points for this particular question, and it's quite helpful, okay? Government of India Act. So that's the first one. So you'll start from 1919, 1935, 1958 salient features. You must have a clue on this. Ab main ye nahi keh rahi isko rat lo. Lekin ye portion kahan pe likha hai aapki consti ki book mein, wo identify kar lo. Theek hai? Usse pehle, let me just give you a list of the books. Wait. Let me give you the list of the books. We had a list of the books. Yeah. I'll also give you a case law list, which will really help you in consti. Okay. Shut this. Okay. So this is a study book list, which I always sort of tell people, plus the notes that I'm giving you. So you must have previous year's salt papers, okay? So you have one called Thakral Law Publications, which is quite useful, or an RK or a PK Pandey, sorry, as it says on the screen. There's one by Lavdeep Bangia, which is again salt papers, 2011 up until 18. So these are, you can just pick one. You don't have to buy all. Just pick one of the books with salt papers. And definitely, I would say, get all of the bare acts, okay? So you have to have the Indian Penal Code, the Criminal Procedure Code, the Evidence Act. You have to have all subjects bare acts, because that is very, very important. There are direct questions for section number or title, like I said. And that's about 30% of the syllabus. So the index becomes crucial of these bare acts, okay? So whether it's Consti, CPC, Criminal Manual, Indian Contract Act, Partnership Act, Sale of Goods Act, Limitation Act, Registration Act, Indian Arbitration Act, Central Civil Laws Manual. This is what you have to carry, okay? So ye likh lo, ek to Central Civil Laws ki manual aati hai. Ye jo teen acts aate hai, Indian Partnership Act, Sale of Goods Act, Limitation Act, Registration Act. Registration Act mein section 17 aur 18 se kaafi questions aate hai. Theek hai? Ye pakka questions hai jo aayenge. Almost, theek hai? Arbitration se 34 pe question aa sakta hai, 11 pe question kaafi aata hai, arbitral appointment and challenge to arbitral awards, okay? So ye, and then of course, now latest off late foreign awards is in vogue also. So agar nahi bhi karna category 2 ka subject, to category 2 ka wo subject kar jao, ka subject ka sorry, wo portion kar lo jo tumhe lagta hai ki aayega. For instance, Limitation Act section 5 is crucial and peeche ek schedule hai, वो ऊपर ऊपर से देख लो. सो यू जस्ट हैव टू रीड इट लाइक अ स्टोरी बुक. ये तुम्हें पता होना चाहिए क्या हो रहा है, ठीक है? क्रिमिनल मैनुअल, मतलब ये चार तो बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट है. दीज आर सुपर इंपॉर्टेंट. खुद को भूल जाना, पर ये मत भूलना एग्जाम में, ठीक है? कॉन्स्टी, सीपीसी, क्रिमिनल मैनुअल, दिस ऑल्सो हैज द एविडेंस एक्ट. आई डोंट नो व्हाई दिस हैज नॉट बीन रिटन हियर. एंड ऑफ कोर्स द इन कॉन्ट्रैक्ट एक्ट. सो दीज आर वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, राइट? And like I said, family laws, I'm not sure how many of you are keen in, but it's basically Hindu Marriage Act, Guardians and Wards Act, Family Courts Act, and the Shariat, portions of Muslim law also. So, ye bhi ek aspect aa jata hai, but ye mat karna agar time nahi. Acha, now there are some subjects of category 2 for which you don't need to prepare. Okay, they are very direct questions. If you just look at your screen, they are very, very direct questions. You just have to carry the Bare Act. Ye wo wale sawal hai jo aapko sirf Bare Act leke jana hai. Consumer Protection Act, TOPA, Transfer of Property Act, Land Acquisition Act, Motor Vehicles Act, Labor Laws. Agar koi subject interesting lagta hai, to usko padh lo, no problem. Lekin, All India Bar Examination ke liye aapko zyadatar bataur in papers ko padhne ki itni zarurat nahi hai. It's fine even if you leave it, but you must have a bare act. Because last ka jo 1 hour hoga na, usme you can attempt all these questions. They say probably it's written that when is a particular factory called an industrial area? Okay, when it has more than 20 workers, when it has, or when is the Factories Act applicable? When it has more than 20 workers, when it has more than 15 workers, when it has more than 10 workers, when it has more than 18 workers. Now I may not know this directly. Okay, this figure, magic figure of 20. But if I look at the Factories Act, if I look at the Industrial Disputes Establishments Act, I may find this figure somewhere. So these direct questions aapko bare act se aksar mil jayenge index dekhne se. Acha, certain books are quite useful. Okay, ye books leke jana. For instance, you don't have to read these books, but ye books leke jana. Is book mein aapko jo questions milenge, wo milte julte honge All India Bar Examination. एक तो मुल्ला ले जाना फैमिली लॉ की, अगर नहीं भी पढ़ना तो वेरी यूजफुल, बिकॉज द क्वेश्चन व्हिच इज आस्क्ड इज वो आपको अपने सब टॉपिक में मिलेगा. फॉर इंस्टेंस अगर आप कोई आपसे कोई पूछ रहा है तीन तलाक के बारे में, पॉलीगमी इन मुस्लिम्स के बारे में, ये आपको सेक्शन 2 ऑफ द शरीयत की इंटरप्रिटेशन में मिल जाएगा. तो मुल्ला की फैमिली लॉ में आपको ये मिल जाएगा जहां सेक्शन 2 एक्सप्लेन्ड है. तो ये चीजें यू विल हैव टू बुक योरसेल्फ, यू विल हैव टू अक्वेंट योरसेल्फ विद द बुक्स अ लिटिल. सो द होल कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ पर्सनालिटी डेवलपमेंट vis-a-vis AIB is that you have to be in a preparatory environment for the examination mentally more physically than. Okay, so what I'm trying to say is you have to know where what is. It's not an exam of sheer memory only. There is, of course, memory. As a lawyer, we need to remember everything that we see, eat, sleep, breathe. Okay, but technically, this is an examination of awareness. You have to know where what exists in the book. And if you're aware, you may be able to do better than someone who's probably read all of those books at that point in time, because time is crucial again. It's of the essence. Another very, very important book, which I recommend you take to the examination hall physically, because it's an open book exam. You take the Law Guide for Judicial Services Examinations. It's a 3-volume set by Dr. Ashok Jain, which is a very, very useful book. Okay, so this is very, very useful to carry. Now, I'll have to check post-COVID if there's been any development with respect to all of this. We'll check that in a few minutes. I'll also have it checked. But this is something, these are 2 tips that I always give to the kids, that everyone criticizes a Bhangia, but carry the Law of Torts by Bhangia. Okay, take it in the exam hall. It's a very, very helpful book. Almost all your questions on torts will get sorted from there. You can safely leave, okay, these subjects, like I said, whether it's a tax, environment, admin, IPR, don't worry too much. If you're not interested too much in it, have an opinion. If you feel that, you know, you like IP, then it's something you must read. If you feel you like tax, you must read it. But if you don't worry too much. Just carry Malcolm Shaw's book for public international law, okay? This book is also very, very useful. It used to come as a green colored book about 10 odd years ago, gosh, I feel old. This used to come about 10 or 12 years as a green colored book. I don't know if the colors change now. But anyway, Shaw is an excellent book for PIL, which you can take. Please don't carry books like Brownlee, etc. Itni moti moti kitab, koi padhne ka time nahi hota, theek hai? Now comes the most important tip, which I'm giving you now. Please make your own law notes. This is the very, very, very crucial tip. So about 3 weeks or 2 weeks before the exam, make a leading cases list. This has to be a case law based question list. Okay, so law notes ka matlab ye nahi ki aap torts khol ke baith jao aur notes banane lag jao, 4 din lag jayenge, kuch nahi hoga. Par case laws ki ek list bana lo. Jaise for instance, consti mein aapko pata hai Keshav Nanda, Vaman Rao, Minerva Mills, ye important hai. Indra Sani reservations ka case important hai, abhi off late chal raha tha. Also, what's happening in the news can get reflected in the exam. So right now, I think the Supreme Court has just given another judgment. They've sort of analyzed the reservation issue, because again, 50% se bahar ja raha hai when you include the OBC reservations, etc. So very interestingly, Indra Sani has been re-looked at. So there could be a question on Indra Sani contempt, Supreme Court Advocate on Records Associations case, SR Bomai case, if there's been a hung assembly, Speaker's power, Shah Bano's case recently, polygamy and triple talaq, Shaira Bano's case, all of these have been in question. MC Mehta's cases for environmental law, kuch nahi padhna environmental law mein mat padho, theek hai, lekin aap ek MC Mehta ka case padho ki theek hai ye 4 cases mujhe karne hai MC Mehta ke, that will help you. And of course, like I said, latest case laws matter. So 2020 and 2021, you have to be abreast with the news. ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. अभी ऑफ लेट दैट रेसलर सुशील कुमार, उसको पकड़ा गया था. युआपा बहुत लोगों पे लग रहा है, यू नो, सिंपल थिंग्स लाइक आर्टिकल 21. सो यू कैन एक्सपेक्ट कि कॉन्स्टी के एग्जाम में, शायद कॉन्स्टी के पेपर में आर्टिकल 21 पे तो क्वेश्चन होगा ही होगा, बिकॉज दैट्स राइट टू लाइफ एंड लिबर्टी व्हिच कैन नेवर बी टेकन अवे विदाउट द ड्यू प्रोसेस ऑफ लॉ. सो वेरी वेरी इंटरेस्टिंगली, सॉरी फॉर दैट टाइपो, आई जस्ट नोटिस्ड इट. सो वेरी वेरी इंटरेस्टिंगली, दीज आर सिंपल सब्जेक्ट्स दैट यू कैन डील विद, ठीक है. अच्छा, अब कुछ इलस्ट्रेशन बेस्ड क्वेश्चन होंगे, ये थोड़े से टफ होते हैं, इनको छोड़ के एंड में करना, इस पे टाइम मत वेस्ट करना. तो कुछ क्वेश्चंस होंगे जो आपको एक हाइपोथेटिकल सिनारियो देंगे. सम क्वेश्चंस विल प्रेजेंट देमसेल्व्स विद अ हाइपोथेटिकल सिनारियो, लाइक फॉर इंस्टेंस ए वाज वॉकिंग टुवर्ड्स बीज हाउस विदाउट प्रोवोकेशन फ्रॉम बी, ए पिक्ड अप अ मेटल रॉड एंड हिट इट ऑन बीज हेड, व्हाटएवर व्हाटएवर. ओके, सो ऑल ऑफ दीस क्वेश्चंस आर इलस्ट्रेशन बेस्ड. So these are a little tough, I would say, unless and until you know that this particular illustration deals with this particular section, don't waste too much time on it, right? Okay. Now, this is one tip which I also give a lot of people, that there was this material which came from Rainmaker. Okay, and this was a private organization which used to, of course, hold the bar examination, All India Bar Examination, in the first 1 or 2 years, something like that. There are two books which have been doled out by the AIBE Rainmaker material. And this is though a 2010 development, this material gives you the basic concept of all the laws. Okay, basic concept. This is a useful material to carry in the exam physically. Okay, right. Also, you can solve previous year's papers of the AIBE with the Bare Acts, etc. So all of that is important, right? Now, one tip which I want to give you before I go down to subject specifics is that you have to have certain basic information, like when was the Act enforced? How many sections are there in the Act? The definition section is usually section 2 of every Act. What is the object? What is the amendment? So these are easy tips that I can give you. कि ये आ सकता है exam में कि act and act कब हुआ था, enforce कब हुआ था, कितने sections हैं, definition क्या है इस term की, objective क्या है, amendment कब हुई थी, etc. etc. ठीक है? अच्छा. जब prepare कर रहे हो next, जब prepare कर रहे हो, do one subject fully. जैसे if you are preparing for IPC, then finish IPC. ये नहीं कि आप IPC से CRPC चले गए, evidence चले गए. This will confuse you a bit because you won't remember in that book where what is placed. Aur aapko ratta nahi marna. Aapko yaad rakhna hai wo concept kahan likha hai. That is enough. That will help you get the answer. Theek hai? Right. Okay. Now let's come back here. Now if you look at this, I'm coming back to Consti Law, right? Now when you look at Consti Law, one of the most important things to remember is Government of India Act. You also see the features of Indian Constitution. ये बहुत important है कि किस country से हमने कौन सा feature borrow किया है, ठीक है? Schedules important है Consti के, schedules. और amendments कुछ कुछ important है, जैसे 42nd amendment is very important, 1976. Mini Constitution बोलते हैं इसको, ठीक है? 42nd amendment, mini Constitution. This is a very 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 important amendment. इससे सवाल आता है, 47th, 48th, 42th. ये कुछ अमेंडमेंट्स हैं जिनसे क्वेश्चन आएगा ही आएगा, ठीक है? इंडिया का कैरेक्टर, फेडरल, यूनिटरी, कौन से केसेस में बात की गई थी, बेसिक स्ट्रक्चर की, केशव नंदा, दीज आर लैंडमार्क केसेस, इनके बारे में कोई ना कोई ओपिनियन होनी चाहिए. आर्टिकल 12 क्या होती है, स्टेट का कॉन्सेप्ट क्या होता है, लैंडमार्क केस था इसका, एयरपोर्ट अथॉरिटी ऑफ इंडिया, सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट लैंडमार्क केस. आर्टिकल 13, व्हाट इज द लॉ, तो ये तो आइडेंटिफाई करके ही जाना कि कॉन्स्टी की बुक में कहाँ लिखा है. आर्टिकल 12, 13, 14 टू 18 सारे जो एक्ट्स हैं, ये सारे जो हमारे कॉन्स्टी लॉ हैं, एक्ट्स हैं, इंडिविजुअल लेक्स स्पेशियलिस हैं, इन सबके रिस्पेक्टिव आर्टिकल्स कहाँ कहाँ क्या क्या लिखा है, 20, 21, 17, 18, जस्ट हैव अ स्मॉल लुक एट इट. ओल्गा टेलिस का केस क्या था, ओके, देन बेसिक क्वेश्चंस. आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू मच डिटेल बिकॉज यू नो वी विल नेवर बी able to finish on time, but I'm just telling you, Puttuswamy judgment, right to privacy of late has come out. It's so important. Article 22 is very important as well. So, ये कुछ चीजें हैं जो आप touch कर सकते हो, ठीक है? सारी constitutional amendments की table बनी हुई है उस judiciary की book में, उसको flag कर लेना कि amendment table. तो जरा सा झट से question आए, what is the 24th amendment? फटाफट वो table खोल के you're able to answer, okay? So this is quite simple, but you can still sort of have an opinion on it, okay? Right. Okay, now there are certain aspects of IPC and CRPC which can come as questions. For instance, section 320 of CRPC pe bahut question aata hai, compoundable offences, okay, criminal procedure code. I've cut Consti now, we finished Consti, I'm just moving to CRPC, IPC. IPC mein kuch bahut important cheeze hain, jaise defences hain, investigations hain, wo sab bhi CRPC aur IPC mein deal hota hai. लेबर लॉज में इंडिविजुअली डील होता है, रजिस्टर्ड ट्रेन यूनियन क्या होती है, एनवायरमेंटल लॉज लाइक आई सेड नैरोबी कॉन्फ्रेंस, स्टॉकहोम डिक्लेरेशन, वियना कॉन्फ्रेंस, रियो कॉन्फ्रेंस, पेरिस अग्रीमेंट, ये सब कुछ क्लाइमेट चेंज की कन्वेंशंस हैं जो आप देख सकते हो, ठीक है? एविडेंस एक्ट, अब नेक्स्ट आ गया एविडेंस एक्ट, इंडियन एविडेंस एक्ट. इंडियन एविडेंस एक्ट में सेक्शन 101 और 102 बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. आगे का अगर इंटरेस्टिंग लगता है तो पढ़ो, अगर नोट्स हैं तो पढ़ो, वरना डोंट स्पेंड टू मच टाइम. बट ये कैटेगरी 1 सब्जेक्ट है, इसीलिए आपको ऊपर ऊपर से इसको देखना पड़ेगा, ठीक है? सिविल क्रिमिनल सिंपल है, ये आपको करना पड़ेगा. सीआरपीसी, आईपीसी, एविडेंस, दीज आर सब्जेक्ट्स व्हिच यू मस्ट टच, क्योंकि अगर ये टच नहीं करोगे तो बहुत दिक्कत आएगी, राइट? ओके 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 कई बार चाइल्ड विटनेस के बारे में पूछ लेते हैं, नो इम्पेडिमेंट इन एक्सेप्टिंग टेस्टिमनी ऑफ चाइल्ड. ओके, सो दिस वॉज द केस ऑफ अशरफ अली वर्सेज स्टेट. सो दिस वॉज अ दिल्ली हाईकोर्ट जस्टिस सीमा कोहली जजमेंट, शी इज नाउ इन सुप्रीम कोर्ट. तो कुछ ये पूछ लेते हैं. लोक अदालत पे क्वेश्चन आता है कई बार. आजकल ये बहुत कॉन्सेप्ट ट्रेंड चला हुआ है लोक अदालत का, ठीक है. सो देयर इज अ बिग टॉक अबाउट लोक अदालत एज वेल, राइट. ओके, मुस्लिम लॉ आई हैव जस्ट टोल्ड यू, शाह बानोज केस, शायरा बानोज केस इंपॉर्टेंट. ओके, राइट. ओके, एडवोकेट्स एक्ट. सो अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल आस्क मी अबाउट एडवोकेट्स एक्ट, बार काउंसिल ऑफ इंडिया रूल्स. सो टू थिंग्स यू मस्ट कैरी विद यू इन द एग्जाम फिजिकली इज एडवोकेट्स एक्ट. Section 35 talks about disciplinary proceedings. Yeah, likha nahi, I'm just telling you. And Section 24 says who can be given enrollment. Okay, who can be enrolled on the advocate's roll, called as an advocate. So, ye important hai. Dealt with contempt of court. ठीक है, तो contempt of court आता है contempt of courts act से. 1970s का law है ये. तो ये important है और आपको ये चीजें देखनी पड़ेंगी. You'll have to open the Advocates Act and see that there is a distinction between three kinds of advocates. Normal advocates as such, senior advocates and advocates on record. ओके, तो ये एक डिस्टिंक्शन है. फिर एडवोकेट के खिलाफ आप कंप्लेंट कैसे कर सकते हो, फिर डिसिप्लिनरी प्रोसीडिंग्स कैसे होंगी, फिर क्या रेमेडीज हैं उसके लिए, ये सब आपको एडवोकेट्स एक्ट में अच्छे से दिख जाएगा. इसको फ्लैग कर लेना. अच्छा, सीपीसी में कुछ इंपॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट्स हैं जो अक्सर पूछे जाते हैं. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, वेदर इट्स एन इंटरप्लीडर सूट, अ स्पेशल सूट, तो बेसिकली टाइप्स ऑफ सूट्स, और इंजंक्शन या स्टे, ऑर्डर 39 रूल 1 एंड 2 ऑफ द सिविल लॉ, सिविल प्रोसीजर कोड, बहुत पूछा जाता है. तो ये चीज थोड़ा से ऊपर ऊपर से देख के जाना, राइट. ज्यूरिसडिक्शन पे भी क्वेश्चन आता है और रेस जुडिकाटा पे भी क्वेश्चन आता है. दीज आर सर्टेन बेसिक थिंग्स, प्लेस ऑफ सुइंग, ट्रांसफर्स एंड ऑल ऑफ दिस, पर ज्यूरिसडिक्शन, रेस जुडिकाटा, ये तो इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक्स है ही. ओके, इंजंक्शन ऑल्सो आई हैव टोल्ड यू, ठीक है. ऑर्डर 39 रूल 1 एंड 2 ये मैंने बता दिया. एक स्पेसिफिक रिलीफ एक्ट भी होता है जो इसके साथ पढ़ा जाता है. टाइम हो तो देखना, नहीं हो तो ऐसी कोई दिक्कत है नहीं, ठीक है, राइट. CRPC में कुछ सेक्शंस हैं विच आर इंपॉर्टेंट जो देख के जाना. 154, लाइक आई वाज टेलिंग यू, एफआईआर का 154 होता है. सो 154, 173, देन सीआरपीसी में 161, 164 ये भी देख के जाना, ठीक है. 200 देख के जाना, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. सो दीज आर सर्टेन बेसिक, जो एक कहते हैं ना बेसिक इन्फॉर्मेशन जो आपको है वो लेके जाना. पब्लिक इंटरेस्ट लिटिगेशन होती है PIL में, तो पब्लिक इंटरेस्ट लिटिगेशन कैसे लगाते हैं, उसमें सफिशिएंट इंटरेस्ट टेस्ट होता है, एटसेट्रा एटसेट्रा. तो फॉर द ऑल इंडिया बार एग्जामिनेशन प्रिडोमिनेंटली यू हैव टू बी अवेयर दैट दिस पर्टिकुलर एग्जामिनेशन इज देयर टू टेस्ट योर नॉलेज इन टर्म्स ऑफ ऑल्सो प्लेसिंग ऑफ द मटीरियल. ओके, so this is perhaps the best that you can do in terms of collating as much material and having case law notes. okay, so case law hona chahiye aapke paas, kyunki shayad aapko bare act mein wo case law na mile. okay, so that is very very crucial, that is very very important that you have these individual topics flagged, marked out, and you may have just cursorily even perused them, that's fine, but you should know where they exist and how they exist. okay, so that is one thing you need to be careful about. now I just want to check so that there's no changes. I just want to check if this examination is just being convened exactly like that, or is there anything that we need to be careful about. Okay, so I'm just checking that. So it's an offline mode exam, perfect. So there's no difficulty, and I think it's a 210 minutes and it's an offline mode exam. Okay, so great, we're sorted. It's not an online exam, which I was thinking that maybe like the hybrid option, they have the option, but no, it's absolutely an offline exam. And it's definitely not going to be a computer exam. It's going to be a paper exam. Okay. If anyone has any questions for me, and ma'am, if you can just take it over from here, and then we can just take the questions as well. I'll be happy to answer. Yes.
Sure. Malika, please take over.
Ma'am, first of all, I have a question. Mm-hmm. There was a recent notice of BCI that the exam is now conducted, is not an open book test anymore.
Yes.
So what about that?
So I think this is one of the most tricky portions, because I think when we all prepared for the AIBE, we had this concept in mind. So by this, I also don't mean that if you can't physically carry everything, the placing in the mind should be such that you have an a rough idea about things. Okay, so if someone says section 35 is disciplinary proceedings, you should know mota mota ki disciplinary proceedings mein kya hota hai. Let me give you an example. So let's take a specific subject specific example. Let's take this only 35 only. Let me just take it out so that you guys can make your note also. Okay, so if you look at professional misconduct when it comes to the advocates, section 35 talks about punishment of the advocate for misconduct. So when I say Advocates Act, you need to identify the important sections. So suppose let's go to Advocates Act. Let's look at section 35. So this is one act section which I know is important. It has a question based on 35. Now what I need to do is I need to read 35 at home. I need to study this. I need to flag it. So I need to know where it exists. So if you know 35 exists here, you read it. Now, 35 says if there's a complaint which is received, otherwise a state bar council has reason to believe that an advocate on its roll is guilty of professional or other misconduct. So there could be a question which says, what is the test when it comes to section 35 of professional misconduct? So now you have to dwell this from this section and Supreme Court advocate on record bar examination versus that case law. Okay, AOR, Supreme Court Advocate on Record, Bar Association case law. That talks about the powers of contempt, to punish for contempt when it comes to an Advocates Act violation, which is happening on both sides. So these are questions which you have to sort of ask yourself when you're reading the study material. So by this, I just don't mean that by flagging, it doesn't mean you're blindly flagging the material. It also means you're absorbing the material. So if you look at, say, a section 35, you say, I need to make a complaint or there is a suo moto action taken. Otherwise, if it feels, the state bar council concerned, prima facie, if it has reason to believe, can initiate disciplinary proceedings, and there will be, the matter will be referred to a disciplinary committee, which will fix a date of hearing. It will issue a show cause notice to the concerned advocate, to the advocate general of the state. The opposition will come. They will now hear this particular advocate. They will hear the advocate general of the concerned state also. And finally, they can dismiss the complaint. They can reprimand, they can scold the advocate, they can suspend the advocate also, they can remove his name from the rolls also. All of this information is coming in the Bare Act itself. So it doesn't mean that you just blindly go on flagging the material. It also means that you please read the material. Now, obviously, because 5 years you were supposed to have studied, now is not the time to study. But still, if you haven't, then I would say certain important aspects you can focus on. For instance, like I'm giving an example of 35. Now see 24 or even in 35, if you see two more things I'll do and then I'll come to that. Even if you see 35, you will see that misconduct as a word is not defined in 35 Bare Act. So you'll have to do this research that you'll have to Google, that you'll have to find out if you've not kept your notes intact. So this is not an examination which you ace in one night anymore. This is a sustained study of over 5 years that you've done, which is now culminating into this 210 minutes examination. Okay, so it's not like it's a palak jhapkai or ho gaya. So by flagging, I don't mean blindly ki aap material ko flag nahi karenge, aap material ko flag karenge aur sab material leke chale jayenge. I'll also have this checked once, but I believe that without the Bare Acts, now if it's a without Bare Act, if it's without Bare Acts that it says, then you have to be very, very careful that if it's a without Bare Act material, then you have to specifically focus on important aspects. I'll give you some important aspects so that it helps you. For instance, in CRPC, let's start with the first one. Criminal Procedure Code, definitely look at the first 10 sections. Okay, it tells you where is a metropolitan area, what is the power and the judicial hierarchy of the courts. And Section 2 gives you certain defense definitions with respect to bailable, non-bailable offenses. What is a bailable offense? What is a non-bailable offense? What is a cognizable? What is a non-cognizable offense? So first 10 to 15 sections are dealing with just this. Then there is one on 154 jump of FIR. There's one on 173 jump of charge sheets. There's one on private complaints, section 190 and 200. So read these together, okay? Then you can go down to appeals, revision, reviews, which comes in 397 onwards up until 401, etc. So CRPC, you can scatter the scheme and then you can come back to 157. Where the investigating officer starts investigation and then he records witness statements, 161. He also asks the 164 statement before the magistrate to be recorded. So coupled with DK Basu guidelines, okay? So interesting web you have to make. You have to go back to your earlier readings. You can't expect this to be a one-stop shop. You have to go back to your readings, make notes. have about 10 pages of CRPC ready as notes so that you can read that one evening before the examination. I'll also have this checked in the meantime. Yes, I hope this suffices you to an extent. Runal.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Okay, no problem.
Does someone have any questions?
Ask me subject-specific questions if you guys are interested. There's no problem at all. We can definitely go down to that detailing also.
Yeah. Kavya has asked a question.
Yes.
She says, can we apply for AIBE now? Currently, we do not have the law degree.
No, you'll have to wait. Okay. So you guys will require that to make your application for your AIBE because it's a subsequent, it's an aftermath of once you get enrolled as a lawyer. This is one of those post-enrollment criteria which you have to fulfill to appear in court. So you have to first get enrolled with the State Bar Council. And once, as per Section 24 of the Advocates Act, you're on the roll of a particular State Bar Council, that's when... So aap jahan bhi practice karna chahte ho, Kavya, I'll answer this question even more simply. Suppose you want to practice in Delhi, you must get yourself enrolled with the Bar Council of Delhi. AIBE is an examination which is organized by the Bar Council of India. It's a pan-India examination. It has nothing to do with state bar councils. It's an all-India examination, which is basically organized by the Bar Council of India. It's like the Supreme Court of all the bar councils, okay, of the concerned states, to put it in a very layman language for all of you to facilitate, to understand. And once you are done registering with your concerned state bar council, suppose kisi ne Bihar mein registration kara liya, kisi ne Mumbai mein sanat le li, kisi ne Delhi Bar Council of Delhi, BCD has its office on the Siri Fort institutional area. Someone gets registered, enrolled as an advocate over there. Once you get that BCD registration number, like say for instance, my registration number comes in 2013, you'll get a 3-4-digit number, which will be your registration number for life. And for life, that concerned state bar council will govern you unless you become an advocate on record. Like I'm an advocate on record now after passing the exam. So now Supreme Court of India governs me. Okay. So only AORs are governed by Supreme Court. The rest, all of the advocates, even senior advocates, they are governed by the concerned bar council, their state bar council. Certificate of practice comes from All India Bar Examination. This is Bar Council of India. This has its office at ITO at New Delhi. Okay, so this is a slightly different organization. Ye hum baad mein karenge. Pehle hum advocate ban jayenge, enroll ho jayenge, uske baad hum COP ke liye apply karenge. Yes.
Thank you so much. The next question is from Samarth. He says, how important is it to give bar exam if someone needs to go abroad for the further studies?
Excellent question, Samarth. Okay. Excellent question. I say this out of sheer personal experience because I was working with Amarchand Mangaldas for about a few months until I left and I fell in love with litigation and I decided to pursue my higher studies at the University of Oxford. And I think that's where my whole career path changed. But I was intelligent enough. I gave my AIBE exactly when I passed. I gave my All India Bar Examination. We were the first batch in 2013 to take the All India Bar Examination test. First or the second, maybe you'll have to check. But I think we were one of the first few batches. And I remember because I had taken that examination, when I decided to come back after a few years, after working with the MICT, the Mechanism for Criminal Tribunals at The Hague, when I decided to come back, my practice now gets counted from when? My seniority counts from 2013. If I wouldn't have taken the AIBE, in hindsight, I would have been penalized. I would have lost out on my years of seniority. Now I apply for a panel and I say that I have 7 years of practice because I have that certificate of practice. So I insist and I urge all of you to most definitely sit for the All India Bar Examination because it opens another window. So even if you don't want to practice now, maybe cut to after 10 years, your mind changes, or you want that door open that you are able to go and appear in a court, even if you don't do it on a daily basis. You should have the ability to open the door at any point in time as you like. So I would say definitely take the AIB. It's also a good certificate to annex when you're making your LLM applications. We can have another session on probably this, that how to apply, probably get a scholarship and how to apply. And then I can also dwell on these issues. But predominantly, I would insist that you take the All India Bar exam because it's not a very tough exam. And even if you get an added certification, why not? You know, it helps you tomorrow if you want to be a judge, you want to be a senior advocate, your years of practice will be counted from then. Okay, so that helps, of course, augment the number of years in that sense. Yes.
Thank you so much. The next question is related to what you just said. Would passing the AIBE in any way increase the chances of getting admission in LLM in US or Canada?
सबको बस पकड़ के जाना है यहाँ से बाहर, किसी को यहाँ नहीं रहना है. No, so I think one of the best places to practice, before I answer this question, is India. And I can tell you the career graph spurt that you will see, okay? The increase, not a plateau, but the increase, the sudden increase that you'll see after about 5 to 7 years, whether you're on the corporate side, whether you're on the commercial side, or whether you are on the dispute resolution side, plainly, even if it's civil and criminal, will be magnanimous. It's fantastic a space, okay? So go out, study, but keep your options open. Please don't be caged, don't be shackled to the effect that you say, you know, you just want to go out, you want to leave the country. A lot of things will change. You know, you experience, you're a second-rated citizen, etc. A lot of different approaches come in. You age, different things take priority, okay? So keep your options open. And that's why I think it's very, very, very good to take the AIB exam. I think this sort of answers the question, but I'll be more specific. It says, would passing the AIB in any way increase chances of getting LLM admission? No, there's no perfect answer to this. And perhaps I'll require another hour to tell you how to make a perfect application when it comes to an LLM or a BCL or anything that you're applying to, whether it's Oxbridge or whether it's one of the Ivy Leagues at the Harvard or wherever, Yale, etc. But I think one thing I can say is that anything and everything that adds to your CV is an asset. I call it the X factor, okay? So when you're making an LLM application, you must have something different. So these are all the ancillary aspects. So if you say that you're a debater, you're a mooter, and you have a certificate of practice, it shows that you're probably interested in dispute resolution, going to court, you may want to shadow a Queen's Counsel outside or whatever. So this shows your interest, you can develop it in your statement of purpose. So this is more like the corroborating factors, may not be the most important one, but it can definitely help you strengthen your application, if not be a maker or a deal breaker rather when it comes to selection in an LLM application. Kunal.
Thank you so much for the answer. I guess these are all the questions. Does someone have to ask something?
Feel free. I'm all yours. I have another 10 minutes. Please.
If anyone wants to ask anything, they can write it in the chat box.
Everybody wants to go for higher studies. Maybe we can have a session on this. I think it'll be quite a popular one, subject to ma'am's approval. Okay, question we'll not take. This question we will take in the LLM session.
Okay, the same question. This is the same question only.
Yes.
Okay, please, someone asked a different question. Okay, someone has asked a question. Yes. When do the forms will get out for the next year bar exam?
This is difficult to say. It's a biannual exam, but I think with COVID, so many things have changed. I think they didn't even have it for a few couple of months. They delayed it last year. They had one. So I think so far, so good. They've come out with the one that's coming in on 14th of October, if I'm not wrong, 14th or 15th, something like that. So I think definitely just wait and watch. Even the AOR examination has been delayed, but I think the wave has now become stable and we'd probably have some good times to come with offline studies and examining. So this is a tough question to answer. We'll have to wait and watch.
Sumata has asked a question. Do we have to worry about plagiarism in the exam?
No. Okay, so there's nothing really that you need to dwell too much in terms of plagiarism. This is not something that you need to in a All India Bar examination. There's no difficulty. Yes.
Nashresh has asked, I prefer preparing for the exam of any investigating agency instead of LLM. Please guide.
Okay, so investigating agencies are CBI, are NIA, okay? ED, how do you get into these investigating agencies? It's not as easy. You cannot become an investigating officer as such. Either you pass the UPSC examination or you pass, say, some examination apart from the law, whether it's years of probably practicing as a public prosecutor, you get appointed as a CBI PP or maybe an EDI public prosecutor or even in a normal practice, an additional public prosecutor, an APP, and then with seniority, join an investigating agency. So I'm not sure what kind of an investigating agency you're talking about. If you want to go into the police force directly, you want to be an IPS officer, you want to be an IAS officer, or you probably want to be a lawyer who practices for a few years and then joins the government as a standing counsel, or maybe a panel counsel for CBI matters, or a nominated counsel. But this is very far-fetched, okay? For all of this, you will first have to become a lawyer. You will first have to give your examination, your AIB, etc., get into the profession, and cut to LLM. Now, everybody asks me this question, whether you should go for an LLM or not. And my answer to this is simple. If you're getting a scholarship, please go by all means. And I think for this, we'll need probably more time to discuss the pros and cons. But I think I always tell everyone this. If you're getting a scholarship, it's an experience in itself. Please go by all means. And if you're not, then see your financial situation. See your future, what you want to do, where. If you want to probably settle outside, you want to look for a training contract, you want to come back, you have family responsibilities here. What do you want to do? So this is completely specific. It's a tailor-made question, I think. And this is where your statement of purpose walks in, your SOP. And that's where you justify your need for funding. You justify your need for foreign education, etc. Because such good universities have now come up in the country as well. So it's not as simple as saying that, should I do an LLM or should I just join practice? This is a call you need to take. And perhaps it's a discussion for about an hour that we need to have properly. Yes. I'll be happy to convene this subject to their approval, and we can definitely do this at some point. Yes.
Thank you so much, ma'am. The next question is from Ananya.
Yeah.
Do in-house legal counsel have to surrender their license?
Absolutely. I think this is a fantastic question. The moment you are not practicing, Ananya, the moment you are not appearing in court, you're not litigating in court, you have to intimate. Now you become a solicitor. You don't have to surrender. You have to intimate. That intimation is deemed surrender. So you say that I'm joining a particular law firm when I'll not be appearing in court. Okay. Now, if you don't want to appear in court, you want to be a solicitor, then you don't even take the AIB. It's fine. But tomorrow, if there's a need that you need to file your wakalat and argue, you will not be able to fill in for a senior. Okay. So the moment you're an in-house legal counsel, yes, you intimate. Suppose I'm working, I'm practicing, I have an AIBE certificate. Say I'm practicing for 10 years, and in the 11th year, I decide to join Times of India as their legal counsel. Now I become a senior legal associate there. I'm an in-house and I have to be promoted as partner maybe at some point. After 10 years of practice, I decide I'm moving in-house. I'm a corporate counsel. Now at this point in time, I have to intimate my concerned state bar counsel as well as the Bar Council of India that, look, I'm no more practicing in a court of law. I've joined in-house. I'm a corporate in-house counsel. Now my license is, it's in limbo, let's say. It's sign or die, okay? So now I have to wait, or I have to intimate them for 5 years. I have my contract for 5 years. Please keep it in limbo. So many readers, so many Ahmeds who are working in our courts actually are doing law. They're studying law. They take the All India Bar examination. They surrender their license saying, we have a government job. We cannot work here. We cannot practice and actively appear in court, but we want to keep the license intact. So definitely you can surrender it, but it's kept intact. And then you can, it's like that MTNL phone connection, okay? You temporarily disconnect, you keep the instrument carefully. And once you want the connection back, you sort of reinsert the wire in and it's working fine. And they will keep the portal open. It's like that somehow, if I can explain it for the lack of a better layman example. Yes.
Thank you so much. The next question is, as we see, many of our politicians are advocates. So do they carry their license while not practicing?
So, Samarth, thank you. Sorry, I cut you, because I think this boils my blood a lot, because there's a settled Supreme Court judgment now on this aspect. It's very interesting that all of you are talking to me about this. But there was a PIL, a public interest litigation, which was filed before the Honorable Supreme Court of India, wherein it was specifically pleaded that you must not allow politicians to become advocates and vice versa, because that takes away from the sanctity and there is a possible conflict of interest. For instance, I'm not going to name anyone, but there are a lot of sitting MPs who also practice as lawyers, where they appear against the government and they are themselves nominated on the tickets of the government, sitting in the Lok Sabha or Rajya Sabha. Now, this is interesting because in court, they have a divergent view. They are fighting applications against the sitting government. They're appearing, they're pleading on a client's behalf. So absolutely, I think this is important, that when the parliament is in session, they must surrender their license. Like I said, it's like a phone connection, okay? But the Supreme Court said, no, we're going to allow certain politicians. Like I said, it's the phone connection. The moment you're not in power, say for instance, a Kapil Sibal, etc., say an Abhishek Manu Singhvi, when Congress is not in power, and maybe they're in the Rajya Sabha, etc. They're also appearing actively in court. Okay, so this is a settled law today. There was, of course, a PIL filed, but the Supreme Court said, no, we are going to allow, we're not going to refuse. This is not like other professions. When we can allow a doctor to be a politician, we can allow an engineer to be a politician. Why can't we allow a lawyer also to be a politician concomitantly and practice in both places? Okay. So definitely when they're not acting as politicians, they're not in power, they can work as advocates. But once they get on the MP seat, they're drawing a salary fixed from there, they will surrender the license during that tenure. Okay. Yes. They will inform the BCI.
Thank you so much for the answer. This is my question for you. What is your opinion on this question? What is your opinion on this scenario? The politician
on which scenario? The politician scenario. I don't agree with it. I really feel, and I think she picked up on my sentiment or emotion, which I don't want to discuss publicly because as lawyers, we're not allowed to comment. I think especially after the latest notification, which has come probably a month ago, we're not allowed to comment on matters publicly and in the media. We're not allowed to even comment on a particular judge's view now. And these are strict rules. And I'll try to abide by that as much as I can. But being a lawyer, I really can't mince my words at times. But I don't agree with this. I feel that if you're a politician, you must be in within the circuit, run the country. And it's great that you have legal knowledge, which is fantastic. But you're drawing a fixed salary. You're working for the people of India. It's fantastic that you're doing that. But I think when you also become concomitantly, you are siding two hats when you're also appearing as a sitting member of parliament on a particular ticket. If you're also appearing against the same sitting government, there's an inherent bias that you will always carry because that particular government gives you the dough, the money. That particular government gives you the perks. You are a known face because of that position. So even if actively you don't want this particular abuse of power to walk in, very subconsciously sometimes also you could have a colored view. So I think I'm pretty sorted. I'm not on the pecuniary aspect too much bothered because I feel that law is also a public service, like probably politicians are supposed to do public services and advocacy also in professional ethics, if you see. It's a social welfare process. It's a welfare of the society objective. It's not to earn money. So the Advocates Act is clear that as advocates, our job is not to earn money. Our job is to actually work for the people, solve their queries. And this is why you have 20 marks for pro bono work when you're being appointed as a senior advocate or a judge maybe tomorrow. So all of you have to show how much pro bono work have you done in the process. So all of this also is a part of lawyering, which is very similar to public service aspect of being a politician. So I think somewhere the lines blur, but I think it's also essential that the two offices be kept intact, or maybe some guidelines can be taken out with, say, that if you belong to a particular political party, you will not appear on behalf of it or against it. So sometimes we have, for instance, like public prosecutors or standing counsels, for whom also we have concrete guidelines and criteria. So I think if that guideline criteria or the concrete specific guidelines could be formulated, that could help strike a fine balance. But Supreme Court did not interfere to that extent. It had a golden chance, but it didn't. Yes.
Thank you so much. I guess these are the only questions we had. We shall conclude the session. Thank you so much, ma'am, for your valuable words.
Thank you.
Thanks
to ma'am also. Please.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you, Shreya ma'am, for your time.
Thank you.
It was a pleasure to have you. Thank you so much,
ma'am. Maybe we can organize a session on the LLM aspect if your kind office approves anytime. And I think that will substantially help them.
Yes, ma'am. I'll definitely give a recommendation to the authorities.
Thank you so much. Can I leave with permission, please?
Yes, thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you so much. Thank you.